The Jack Russell Terrier is an amazing dog breed because it is very versatile. My name is Lynn Clough and I come from Great Britain. I'm an international Jack Russell Terrier, Terrier judge, and I judge all over the world. Bred in the UK as a fox hunting terrier, it has the hunting instincts that can be adapted to do many things. It is very good at racing, very good at barn hunting, go to ground, agility, and very good in the confirmation ring as well. The breed originated in Great Britain. Yes, it was named after Parson Jack Russell, who came from Devon, who worked fox terriers and introduced the breed that we know today as the Jack Russell Terrier. But also there were always white-bodied terriers that worked in different parts of the United Kingdom. Bred from different kind of working terriers, there's always been a white strain. So although Parson Jack Russell was the original person that named the Jack Russell Terrier, there was always a white-bodied terrier that worked in Wales, for instance. The miners would have white-bodied terriers to work foxes in the areas in the Lake District. And this is why we have such different sizes, because in the south of England, the quarry was different. In the north of England and in the Lake District, they'd require a different size dog to do different size hunting. The dogs used to go out with the foxhounds, they'd be carried on the horses. Different dogs in different areas, they had different functions to perform. The Jack Russell was created to work fox underground, to go to ground, to bay to the fox, so that the fox would evacuate the earth and bolt for the foxhounds to catch. The Jack Russell obviously has to be courageous to go to ground. It has to also be intelligent because it has to work its quarry as well. And this is why the Jack Russell now is an intelligent dog and can be adapted to do so many other things. In Great Britain, we have working terriers. So we'll have a Lakeland Terrier, Patterdale Terrier, Border Terriers. They're all working terriers that work underground. But the Jack Russell is the white-bodied terrier. There's nothing really delicate about a Jack Russell Terrier. A Jack Russell Terrier is a big dog in a small package. It has drive, it has courage. It's a sturdy, strong terrier. It has bone and it has heart. The generations of breeding have kept the working instinct going, and the tenacity and the... They're not the easiest of dogs to own. They're difficult. Jack Russell owners are usually very much like their terriers. There's a tenacity about them. There's the tough terrier spirit that keeps them going. Over the years, yes, of course, the breed has changed. All breeds change. It's become more versatile. Whereas it was just a fox dog, it now has many different functions. It has different abilities. I mean, you've seen it all today, the agility, the companion dogs. Because of their intelligence, yes, they can be used for many things. Because the Jack Russell Terrier has a very good sense of smell and can scent, they work by using the sense of smell. So when it's the go to ground, they're in the tunnels and they're actually smelling out. When they're in the barn hunt, they're still using the same, but it's sound as well. And they've got to be flexible. They've got to be able to jump and turn and twist. So they have all those abilities as well. The kennel cub versions of the Jack Russell have taken the original Jack Russell, applied their own breed standards and applied what they want to from the dog. But the Jack Russell was the original terrier, before any kennel club recognition came into play. We don't breed just for show. We breed for hunting ability. We breed for the temperament of the dog. And this is why we have the 10-inch dogs up to the 15 inches. We have the different coats. We have different head shapes. We have different colors. We haven't tried to standardize it. A dog that works has to have a good temperament. And if you are breeding a working terrier, you need a strong terrier that's going to have good chest room, strong bone. You don't want a weak terrier. A terrier needs to have a good coat. If it's out working in all weathers, it needs to have a waterproof coat. But if you've just got a show dog, it doesn't matter so much how thick the coat is. And chest size is very important on a working terrier. The chest has to be the correct size for the dog to go to ground. And in a lot of the show dogs, this is not even an issue anymore. So they're not breeding for a spandable chest. The correct chest size for a working terrier is it should be able to be spanned by a man, average size man's hand. The chest size like that, but I have small hands obviously, but the breed standard says an average man size hands, and that should be the chest side of a terrier, size of a terrier. I think there's more variety in the terrier now with size and height and coat, because there's more of them and they've been bred to do different jobs, not just in Great Britain, in America, but all around the world as well. They're used to hunt different quarry all around the world. People require different things from their Jack Russell Terriers, and over the years that has developed. The original size of a Jack Russell was 14 inches, and the temperament would have been, there would have been a little bit of fire in the temperament. That it had to have a spark, it had to have a strong presence. So yes, Jack Russells can be fiery, but they need to have something that they can do to occupy themselves. They're the kind of dog that needs occupying, needs a job to do. We have tried over the years to breed out the health issues, and every time they come up, the Jack Russell owners take these issues seriously. There were eye problems, and yes, because they were a white dog, there was problems with deafness. They would hop on the back end, their patella problems. But with correct breeding, most of these problems have now been bred out. The Jack Russell is very hardy, it's very physically strong. The average age of a Jack Russell these days can be up to 15 years. They do live, some live longer, but anything from 12 to 15 years is a good age for a Jack Russell, and most of them live to that age these days. They do, yes. They're hardy, they're strong. The Jack Russell Terrier makes a wonderful pet. It's a wonderful companion dog. It's very good at being the kind of dog that will go anywhere with you, will do anything, will travel with you. I mean, there have been dogs here today that have flown on aeroplanes. They're very loyal, they're very good guard dogs. You have to have a fenced-in yard with a Jack Russell because they tend to be busy and into everything, but they make wonderful additions to your family. They're not always so wonderful with other dogs, but individually they're all different. Children, yes, most of them are wonderful with children. It's how they're brought up in the first place, but you've seen all the terriers here today. They're all sociable, they all get on together. As long as the owners are in control, they're absolutely fine. A Jack Russell needs to be in a home with a family and needs to have attention, yes. You know, it's not the kind of dog you can go off and leave all day. They do need a lot of exercise. Out in the park, in the woods, on the beach, that's the kind of thing that a Jack Russell would enjoy, a long, long walk and a very good run. It would be beneficial if you could do that with a Jack Russell, yes. If the dog is left unattended and it is bored, it would tend to chew and would be slightly destructive, yes, yes. If you're going to leave the dog and you're going to go out, it would be best if you crated the dog. You had a crate for the dog so that when nobody was there, it had its own space and its own area. That would be the best thing that I would advise, yes. I mean, I've been breeding Jack Russells now for 40 years, and I hope that the breed continues as a working terrier all around the world. I don't intend to breed anymore, but I judge internationally. I'll be over to America a couple of times every year, and I like to see the way that the breed is developing. I like to come and see new puppies, new breeders, talk to people that are hunting their dogs, go out hunting when I'm over here. And the breed will continue. The American Jack Russell Terrier Club is a very good club, and it promotes the Jack Russells best than they can.